Hello and welcome, everybody. This is The Domain Gaming, and we are presenting you our Mage the Awakening Chronicle. Inna Insten Nergal. And, Pooter, you have won the toss-up. You are giving us the recap.
I won by default.
Pretty much.
I was working on it. Had notes. I rewrote mine.
We'll get back to that. So, we started off where we left off. We saw the lone figure in our burial area where he should not have been. So we went to, well, look around and see what the hell he's doing there. So we didn't see him there, but we found that a body had been exhumed from one of the spots. And strangely, that spot was filled back in, which was weird. Some organs were taken and messed around with. He was missing his stomach, liver, bladder, and I think some others that I can't remember or forgot to write down. I just got those ones down. His kidneys were out and had a bunch of spilled mana on them, which is strange. So I'm going to be studying those at some point. There was a warding spell, and I dispelled it. Hooray. And it was warding some life magic, which I then also dispelled, because I'm awesome. Yeah, the life magic thing was weird, because it's like interacting with these small things. It was really confusing, and they were multiplicating and propagating and whatnot, so I hopefully took care of that in the correct way. So we reburied the body and went to go confront Tordur because after some scouting and dog's keen sense of smell, wolf that he is, we identified his tracks to know that he was the one in our graveyard area. And found out he was basically lying from the start. And he panicked and teleported out. I was not unable to keep him from teleporting out. So we were gonna go look for him. I meant to cast an awesome spell on myself, but it went awry. and went on Catalina instead. And she had a moment of,
I see beyond 3 feet.
She's all the things through all the things. It's an awesome spell and I want it back.
I would give it to you, but...
That's about where we left off, I believe. We had found his little campground through that spell.
Yes, and you guys had returned back to the burial monolith.
Yes.
So, and that is where we're going to pick up where we left off, is at the burial monolith. The paradox of that spell has ended, so... Catalina, your vision returns to normal.
Yay!
As the spell
works. I see nothing.
You see normally now. Does the spell return to me, or is it just gone?
It's gone.
Gah, all that wasted resources.
It wasn't totally wasted.
I mean...
I saw the guy.
Wasted resources.
Yeah. So you guys know that he is in his little makeshift shelter in the foresty area towards Catalina's swamp.
About how far away was he? Obviously within 3 miles.
Yeah. Probably 1.5 miles to 2 miles, somewhere in that range. So, I mean, you guys can start booking it there. Obviously, there's no guarantee that he's just going to stand there for the amount of time it's going to take you to get there.
That's true.
But you guys do have a wolf with you.
Mm.
So, what would the three of you like to do?
Are we going to do, like, a sneak attack? Are we going to keep throwing faraway spells at him.
Well, we're gonna cut him off first.
So we're gonna sneak attack him.
Can you really sneak up on a mage, though? Like,
it's difficult.
Can't we do like a hidey spell?
Yes.
Okay, and then like transform into like an animal. Okay, or somebody can be invisible. Somebody can turn into an animal, polymorph, whatever. And then somebody else can. I feel like somebody needs to come from the air.
yeah, let's just fly real quickly.
Like an aerial attack. Because maybe he was hiding how strong he was. Maybe he's like a super mage.
Well, I mean, I can do two of those things, but it's going to cost, you know, more resources. And I still have some paradox I need to take care of first.
He still has the paradox polluting his pattern. As you guys continue to think, the daylight continues to move forward.
God, I'm just trying to read the book to see duration.
I mean, at this point, would you guys just like to begin your journey in that direction?
What do we do once we catch up to him?
We hit him with a rock.
Oh, so we are going to attack him. Okay.
Well, I mean, he keeps running away. It's like...
So we move up.
No, that was the thought. He keeps running away. I mean, maybe we should stop him from running away, and maybe he'll answer a question or two.
All right. So is everybody in agreement with Catalina going ahead and just moving forward? She's heading there.
Yeah.
With or without you guys.
Yeah, that's fine with me. We do still need some answers, I guess, out of him.
It doesn't take you all that long. Unfortunately, by the time that you guys have arrived at his location, he has already left.
Of course. Now, did he leave by walking or by other means?
How are you wanting to check that? Mage sight or?
Tracks.
Tracks. He left by walking, and if you want to check your sympathetic link or the sympathetic link through the kidney, you can do that as well. However, as you approach his little shack, I need everybody to roll me a, let's see, I know it's going to be a composure check, but composure plus, we'll actually do composure plus resolve.
All right. So that's 6 dice for me. I rolled 1 success.
Okay. Good.
Hey, I win.
We got... need the other 2. 1 success.
Composure plus resolve. Okay, so it's 2 plus 3, so 5. And it's a d10?
Yeah, just roll 10 again. Hey.
Everybody rolled 1 success. The stench emanating from his little encampment is enough to make you guys vomit. However, you guys are able to stifle the gag back down. That doesn't stop the stench, though, from making it an ongoing issue, so to speak. It smells of rotting flesh and just death.
What is that smell? Gah!
Skin? Not...
The smell is emanating from his little makeshift shelter, so whatever's making that smell is inside.
No. If I can't stand the smell here...
And any look at a dog at this moment, he's stopped. He's refusing to move.
He has the right idea. I nominate Igor because he's the only one that's not hacking.
We're all hacking.
I mean, we can just delete it. I feel like that would not help the investigation, however.
Realistically,
I've got to have like a cool spell or something that deletes said dench or something.
Well, I mean, technically, scent are molecules in the air, molecules are matter, so I mean, it is in your preview.
I can make some wind and blow the smell in the opposite direction.
That would help. Just
cast environmental shield. Stench is an environmental effect, right?
I'm not opposed to that thought process, actually.
What could go wrong?
Okay, then make me a dice pool of your Gnosis plus Arcanum. Are you using high speech and any Yantras?
Might as well. I mean, I'm here, so I guess what it's one reach for instant. I think it's a 2-dot cast, so I don't even need the extra reach. I'm not even figuring it out. Sure, one free reach. What's your gnosis? 30.
You could have it affect us.
That's a lot of work, and I don't know how to do that.
You would extend the range with a reach.
Okay, so Yantra's high speech plus your tool is what, plus 3, I think?
Yes.
Good enough. So that should be...
that's a total of
9, I think?
Yeah, that's a 9. So go ahead and give me your roll of 9 dice. 3 successes. You create a barrier that prevents the smell from wafting into your nostrils. You can breathe easy for now, for the duration of this spell. Would you like to approach?
I probably should have made the duration long. Oh. Yeah. I'll approach this whatever makeshift shelter these got and locate presumably the other organs that he took.
As you poke your head into this makeshift shelter, you see what appears to be a large wolf laying dead in the middle of the shelter. But this isn't a wolf like you've ever seen before, as it seems to have 2 forward-facing tentacles extending from its front shoulders, ending in like a spade-like flab of flesh. You guys aren't familiar with squid, but essentially these are squid arms that are coming out of this wolf's shoulders.
Well, that's a freak of nature. shall I delete it? I'm gonna...
No, not yet. What is it?
That's a great question. I'm not an animal person. Get the animal person in here.
Well,
it looks like dog, but squiggly.
Yeah, I've never seen a wolf with tendrils like that.
So, then Kalmir, you also stuck your head in, despite the smell?
Yeah, I'm peeking in, holding my breath as much as I can.
I mean, would you like to scrutinize this or look at it with any sort of mage sight?
I'll look at it with my base 2 mage sight, so not like forces matter, but prime.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I guess like mage sight doesn't cost anything, so I can look at it with death and matter.
It's dead.
Yep.
Yeah, it's dead and matter. As for your prime, you don't notice anything directly about it, but you do notice a bit of supernal drifting away from it and into your, I'm just going to say, pack. The reason I'm saying pack is because I don't know exactly where you're storing the kitten.
I assume I have a satchel that I put it in.
Yes.
Bag, satchel, thingy.
So you actually see supernal energy flowing off of this thing into that satchel where you are keeping the kidney.
How strange. How does that work? Can I study it further? Right, I suppose I would have to take the kidney out and look at it.
Any studying, however, is going to be impeded by the mana that is dumped all over it.
Oh, yeah, that. Well, I have this nifty new thing. Where is it? Cleanse pattern, prime 3. So I can remove the telltale signs of awakened interference.
Okay, so give me the roll for that.
So it's prime 3. That's 7 dice. I get my one instant, or one reach for make it instant. So then again, 7 dice. 2 successes.
More than enough to peel away the mana that was smudging it.
What's happening now? Yes.
With prime, all you can see is that it's absorbing it. You would need other arcana to be able to discern more.
It's so the kidney is absorbing the supernal mana?
Yeah, from the entity that's laying on the ground. The wolf, the tentacled wolf.
Okay. Let's try it with a bit of life in my mage sight.
It seems you have to burn a point of mana for that,
yes.
Correct?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
What's your mana count at? Just so I'm aware.
Oh, I don't remember.
Because you were at full mana for Gnosis 3.
Yeah. Where's the chart?
And I think you've burned, what, 3 or 4 mana?
3.
All right. So what you can kind of discern here, you have a total of 12 mana at Gnosis 3. At
total of 12. So I'm at, what, 8 or 9 now?
Let me get to that in a second, Gandhi.
That's why I messaged it, not just speaking up.
So as you activate the life arcana into your mage vision, you can actually see what looks to be illness flowing from the dead creature. It doesn't look like it died via this illness. It looks like it is the illness. And essentially what you can tell has been done to the kidney was because the kidney's been coated in mana, it's absorbing the illness and purifying it. However, it doesn't seem like the kidney is strong enough to handle something of this magnitude, so it is quickly losing its strength as it does so, and you eventually watch it peter out.
Interesting. So it appears this body part was absorbing the negative supernal energies that this thing was emitting and purifying it, but it's not enough. Maybe because this has been dead for some time that it can't do it? I'm not sure.
Igor, as you investigate the body, you can tell that this thing was killed by a hatchet.
I see.
You can actually find the bloody hatchet sitting on the ground near its body. Nothing special about the hatchet. There's nothing special. It's just your standard, you know, stone tool.
Okay, so because I'm terrible with this system and I feel really bad about it, remind me again how you get more reach. Is it just having more pips in the spell type, or can you burn your dice pool?
That's how you get more, or having a... It's a controlled resource. It's based off of how many dots you have in the Arcanum versus how many dots that spell is. So if you have 3 dots and you're casting a 1-dot version, then you get 2 extra free reach.
Okay, so you can't burn your dice pool to get extra
reach.
Then. All right, so never mind that.
Above it. I mean, you can go above your free reaches, but then you start inviting Paradox.
Yeah, but then I'd be inviting Paradox just to confirm that my suspicion that the wolf clearly... I mean, the wolf clearly attacked our quote-unquote friend here. But I just wanted to confirm it. But it's not worth it.
Okay.
Because I'd either invite Paradox or we'd sit here for an hour.
I wonder how long this creature has been dead.
That is actually something Gandhi would be able to tell, which he has. It's been dead roughly about 3 days at this point.
Okay, well then my theory is completely out the window.
Maybe he self-sacrificed?
Well, he was just here. Why would he leave the body here? Come back here? What are the chances there's a Cthulhu wolf ghost here to speak to? It probably doesn't want to speak to me, even if it was here.
Does anybody have a Ouija board?
Don't exist yet.
Igor's technically a gigantic Ouija board. That's why he's asking.
Yeah.
Oh, are you casting a spell right now?
Not yet. So the mage site for death lets you see manifested ghosts, but that's manifested. So if it was just hanging out in ghost realm in this
you would be
area,
able to see
it, yeah. I would. Okay. Is it?
No.
Okay. Well, I don't speak wolf anyways, so we're good.
And you're not sure, even with your death sight, you're not even sure this thing would have a ghost. Because this thing isn't really natural either.
Well, I propose we get rid of the body and we move on.
Get rid of it? Like, just bury it here?
No, I said just delete it or burn it or something. I don't know. Get rid of it. Doesn't deserve a burial.
Then just let animals.
Okay, this wolf thing is very sick. Clearly, it's got sickness in it. If we let animals eat it, then the animals will get sick.
At this point, I want you guys to make me a perception check, please.
That's Wits, composure?
Yep, wits plus composure, please.
I've rolled two successes.
Everybody's like mimicking each other on the
Stop copying me.
Everybody got two successes. You guys begin to notice that the forest has gone quiet. And that usually means you guys have been, you know, you guys have enough knowledge and survival for you guys to know that. That usually means a predator is about. And that's when you begin to hear the low growl and snarls of dog, followed by immediate whimpering of dog.
Oh, can I, which direction is he facing?
Yeah, he's doing the whole, he's kind of looking in every direction.
I think we're not alone.
And now I am going to do this.
Oh no!
Oh no, don't do it!
Oh no!
At this point, what looks to be almost a twin of the thing that is laying dead on the ground leaps from the brush and tackles dog and bites down on him.
Oh no!
I'm going to kill it.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to kill it. How can
I? Fireball?
I would need initiative rolls if you guys want to fight.
We're not going to outrun a wolf, so.
So we kill it with fire.
So can I get your guys' initiative? For you that don't know, initiative is going to be 1d10 plus your initiative mod. You just said 1d10.
1d10.
Igor got 14.
Did I roll 2?
Hold on. I don't remember the macro. /roll1.
It's /R, and then you can copy what Gandhi has there.
With the parentheses and all that?
No. You see where it says rolling 1d10 plus 4?
Yeah.
You would do /R, 1d10 plus whatever your initial mod is.
1d10. Where's my plus?
So, Nappy, you got that, right?
15.
15? Was for Kalmir?
Yes.
I've been saying that correctly, right?
Yes, Kalmir.
Okay. I'll just roll for Melina, because I don't think she's figuring it out. It's plus 5. So it's /R, 1d10, plus 5 is what you would type. So you got 6.
Wow. Yay. Wow.
Alrighty.
Then last.
Dead last.
Alright, well. Here we go. Now I'm going to roll my stuff.
I don't think I have any good spells. I'm just inconvenient.
So that'll be... Oh, actually, Kalmir, could you roll me one for a dog?
Oh, yes. That's...
Now that I'm thinking about it.
Yeah. So, again, wits, composure?
This is his initiative.
Oh, initiative. What's his initiative? 6. Okay.
Same as these things. That makes sense.
Yeah. Oops. What'd I do?
No, that was me.
Oh, okay. 1d10 plus x 14.
shares one with, or shares his turn with Igor.
Why are you still rolling? How many of these things are there?
It's a pack. All right. So the one that just dove in, I will count that as actually not a surprise round since you guys were noticing him. But that was his turn. So since I got two 16s, the next one comes out of the brush and specifically looks at you guys, placing itself in between you guys and its fellow packmate and dog. Kalmir, you're next.
Me. Well, what's the best way to kill that thing? They're not normal wolves, right? They have tentacles?
Yes.
Okay, so they're strange things. I kind of want to hit it with lightning, but I don't want it to hit Doc. So
there is one blocking you from getting to Doc as well.
That's true. Okay, then I'm going to attack the one between us with my spear, trying to get to Doc.
Okay, these things have a defense of 2, so remove 2 from your dice pool as it applies its defense to you.
Okay, so strength is 3, weapons is 2, that's 5, I got spears, that's 6. Oh, minus 2, so 4.
Mm-hmm.
Dang, no successes.
It twists its body underneath the spear, and you kind of just stab at the air as it snarls at you.
But did it move out of the way?
No. It just hunkered itself down.
Okay.
Now, another one comes out from your left, Kalmir. This one's a little bit closer than the other two. So this one's actually able to reach you. What's your defense?
My defense is 5.
Oh. It only gets one die. Or do you want to apply your defense to it?
I do.
Okay. You see a tentacle lash out, and as the tentacle moves forward at you, you can actually see that spade-like flab get caught in the wind and push back, and it reveals this long bone-like spine that extends out from the tip that the flab would actually lay down over the top of, that just barely misses your shoulder. You can feel the wind of it graze.
I was hoping to find the book section on dual casting before it was my turn, but we didn't find that yet.
I mean, combat is separated into instant and reflexive actions, so I mean, any spell that you reach to make it instant can be used in combat.
Oh, I'm going to need 2 spells, though, for my stupid plan.
So
should be able to cast 2 at 3 Gnosis. I did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what 2 spells are you trying to combine?
So, okay, let me get the correct names. I have too many pages open. One moment. The two spells that I was thinking of was Shaping and Golem. I was going to very quickly make a statue out of something and then animate it with Golem. But I don't know if I can even do that, because I'd need to use a reach for one of them.
Well, you're combining spells into one spell, so this would be technically one entire huge spell.
Yes. So I guess because I would need... That probably wouldn't work if it was going off at the same time.
I mean, you could shape...
I don't even think I have any, like, normal weapons either, so...
You have a rock.
I don't think a rock's gonna actually help me here.
I mean, there are... These things are made of matter.
Yes, but I can only affect inert matter. I can't affect living things. Unless you want to get really min-maxy and say, I'm going to, like, change all the iron in their blood to be something else so they just die of asphyxia. Like, they just run out of oxygen and die instantly. But I don't think that'll work.
I mean, technically, these spells are designed to do stuff like that.
Do it.
He has went dead silent as he contemplates.
I'm trying to think, how am I going to do that? Because I'm pretty sure I'd have to be in touch range.
Yes.
For basically all the matter spells.
Or you can go ahead and change it to a thrown spell, which they get to apply their defense to.
Basically, you'd fire a laser at them.
Yes. It would be, for a D&D reference, it would be a disintegration spell that would have to beat their AC.
Yeah. Are there any in range of me running up and just, like, killing them?
With your bare hands?
Reach any of them, even?
Yes, the one that attacked Kalmir and the one that Kalmir attacked are both within your reach.
Okay. So, here's my plan. I don't know if it'll work, but I'll run up to the...
Oh, that was Gavin.
Yep. We'll go ahead and move on.
Message. There he is. You good?
Okay. I think I'm here. Sorry. Yeah. Okay. Run up to the one that's attacking Kalmir. Cast transmutation. That's not like transmutation. It's... What word is that? I've never seen that word. But
transubstantiation?
Yeah, sure. That's how you pronounce it. I can't speak English, sorry. And then I'm going to transform their blood cells, because they're not... You could argue they're not alive. They don't have a nucleus. They can't repair themselves. What would kill them instantly?
Turning them to stone? I don't know.
Turn like copper.
Copper.
I probably wouldn't let that go, that slide. But it's up to your ruling if blood is alive. Or the iron in their blood, I could change into something else. But I can't
change
the iron in their blood either, so I don't...
Give me your spellcasting roll, please.
Okay. Let me figure out what I have. So it's just one for instance. Sure, I have one free.
Yep, you have one free.
I don't think I'd need to increase potency or duration here. Hold on.
No.
Yeah, okay. So then, three, no sources. So, okay. I'm just doing, I probably don't even need to do that macro, but I don't trust myself to count normally, so I'm doing it anyways.
Yeah, it's more there just for, you know, just to confirm stuff. Three successes. All right. Now, because you were technically targeting the blood, you find out very quickly that this creature doesn't have blood. However, the thing that is keeping it alive still reacts. And it does completely solidify that one into a tentacled dog-shaped copper statue.
Okay, not the intended effect, but it seems to have worked regardless.
Kalmir.
Yes.
Could you give me a strength check for dog?
Strength check for dog. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, it's only a strength 2. 2. No successes.
Since he is involved with a grapple, so. Huh. Well, they both failed.
Right. do they break free of each other? How does that work?
No, it just. Still neither move. Of them can make a maneuver on each other. So at this point, two more leap out from the brush. They aren't quite in range to be able to do anything other than close the distance on dog and the one that's already on top of dog. So at this point, you guys have a total of 4 of these active while one of them is a statue. Catalina, it is your go.
So, I wanted to try control instincts and maybe calm them down, get them from fight mode to chill mode.
Is that a life spell or?
A life spell, part 2. Or 2 dots, I don't know.
Yeah, 2 dots.
I think it works with supernatural beings too.
Control instincts. For all their intellectual powers, humans are animals too, and animals are governed instinct. You would need to apply a reach to be able to do it to supernatural creatures.
Okay.
So, and you have 3 in life, so, and since this is a level 2, you do have the 2 free reaches.
Okay. I wish to attempt this.
Okay, so you would give me your life plus arcana. 1 free reach for instant, 1 reach for to affect supernatural creatures. And then do you want to use high speech and your chalice?
Oh, yes. Yes to all that.
So that's 3 extra dice. So it's 3 plus your arcana plus your gnosis.
Where's my calculator? Okay, so yeah, why doesn't it cancel? There it is. Okay. So I add my arcana, which
to
is
your gnosis.
To my gnosis, which is intelligence.
No, it no. Literally says gnosis.
Oh, I thought gnosis was intelligence. Okay, so 3 plus 3, 6.
Plus another 3, 9.
9 total?
Yes.
So 9. That's it? Okay, I got three.
So, which one were you targeting?
The one biting down on dog. I guess all of us are trying to save dog.
Dog!
Alright, so you go up and touch it, I'm guessing then? Because all spells are touch range unless you throw it at them.
Oh, okay. Yeah? Hesitantly?
Okay, and what are you trying to influence it to do? Because you're trying to change its instinct. Its instinct is currently kill. Yeah.
Well, his instinct is, but is it because he's feeling defensive, hungry?
Unknown.
Oof.
Oh, actually, no. I'm gonna rephrase that.
Okay.
Reproduction.
Get him off a dog.
So not horny is what I need to make him feel, not feel. Is that what you're telling me?
That's a hard question to answer. We'll just say that you're trying to get him off of that feeling. There's a reason I'm saying that.
Okay, whatever feeling he's feeling that makes him want to bite down on dog, I'm trying to make him feel the opposite of that.
When this spell takes hold, the creature just freezes.
Oh, well, it worked.
Just completely and utterly freezes, doesn't move, still has dog pinned to the ground. Doesn't move at all. So now we're back to it. It still is just standing there over the top of dog. Upon dog's next turn, he can act normally. It's no longer an opposed grapple.
So does this mean I know what he's feeling? Or was that out of game knowledge?
That, I would have to double check. I believe it does state you have to know what it is to be able to change it. So I will assume that, yes, you were able to be like, as soon as you touched him and you were casting the spell, you were like, okay, this thing wants to reproduce.
The dog is a boy.
Look over at you. It wants to mate? Kind of look at you, kind of question.
So, Kalmir.
Huh?
Would you like to apply your defense to this next attack?
Of course.
Okay. So the one that's between you and dog attacks again with the tentacle and unfortunately can't seem to get the sticker in you, so to speak.
Well, good. If that sticker is what I think it is.
It's your turn, Kalmir. Kalmir, sorry.
That's Kalmir. Question. Telekinesis is forces 3. Can I use that on these things and lift them up off the ground?
What's the limitation of the spell?
What do you mean?
Like, weight? Is it a potency thing?
Well, potency is for strength for raw lifting, pushing power, dex for fine manipulation, or speed.
And you said, what level was it?
It's a forces 3, page 144, if you want to look at it.
Yeah, I found it. So what are you trying to do with it?
I want to lift them all off the ground. If I can I'd have to extend the scale factor to include them all.
Okay, moving objects using telekinesis requires concentration as an instant action each turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I mean, if you want to go ahead and give it a shot to try and lift them all.
I would like to give it a shot. So obviously one reach for...
It says that the... Oh, you're not doing the plus one reach. Sorry. Okay.
No, yeah, I'm not doing that one. I don't care about that one. So I'm doing the instant.
Aren't you at forces three?
I'm at forces three, yeah. I'm trying to remember.
So you're going to get some paradox chance here.
I might get some paradox. I'm trying to remember if I can use substitute mana instead of a reach for an advanced scale factor.
I know you can use mana to reduce the paradox.
Yeah, I know that much. Where's the scale factor chart? I don't remember. Control F.
For the scale factor, you would take a penalty of -4 for scale for four subjects.
Okay.
That's what it says for standard scale.
Ah. So I can do it.
Yeah, if you want to use mana to make it advanced scale, then there is no dice penalty.
Then I'll do that.
Okay. So that's one mana.
So one mana, one reach for instant, and I target all of the wolf things. Even the ones that aren't moving, even the statue. All of them.
All right. Go ahead and give me the roll. They don't get their defense against this because this... Oh, wait. You're going to need... either you have to throw the spell or you have to make it within sensory range as well.
Ah, and that's a reach, isn't it?
Yep. You either throw the spell and then they all get to apply their defense to it, or you make it sensory range, but that costs a reach.
I'm going to do the reach. I'll risk a paradox. Again.
So that's two. Because you're still at Gnosis 3?
I'm 4 now.
Okay, yeah, you are at...
Does that increase my paradox dice?
That's what I have to double check. It might. I know at 3 your paradox chance, or your paradox die was 2. No, it's still at 2.
Okay.
Okay. So, here we go. No successes, so you're good.
7 dice. Hey, 1 success, that's all I needed.
These creatures begin to levitate into the air. Because you just wanted to lift them up into the air,
right? I want them up in the air, yes.
Okay.
That's my turn, basically.
Yeah, it's Dog's turn now.
That one is lifted off Dog now.
Yeah.
I know I already ended my turn, but how high could I lift them?
I was assuming you had just taken them roughly eye level.
Eye level, okay.
And that's going to be your turn as long as you want to keep them up in the air because it's a concentration thing.
Yeah. So I'll put them all up eye level and then I'll say, well, now what? I'm going to walk out of their reach.
I mean, Igor? It's your / Dog's turn, so...
Yeah, well, Dog's gonna get up and come to my side. That's what I want him to do.
He refuses to move anywhere near those things. He actually tries to put as much distance between him and them.
Well, that's why I said I moved out of its reach.
It's still one of those things.
Okay.
He has...
Doesn't want to be near him.
Yeah, doesn't want anything to do with these creatures.
Okay, so does it cost any like action or whatever to use your active mage sight in combat or
no?
Okay.
That would be reflexive if any.
Okay. So I'm going to look at them particularly with death. Are they dead?
No, they are not dead.
Okay. So that doesn't explain why that other spell worked then. But I'll roll with it. They're all floating in the air.
Eye level. Yep.
Including the one that is now a copper statue.
Okay, well, there goes that plan then.
Good old mages, ruining other people's plans since whenever this game came out.
Of course. Well, I mean, I guess I can try again and just insta-kill one, attempt it again. Are any in reach? Or
you can easily walk up to one and touch one.
Well, I mean, they were just trying to mate.
I don't want this thing. Any more of these things? I'm going to kill this thing.
You're right. Okay, hold on. I need to look at... what do I have for fire?
What?
I know what he's going for here.
Burn it with fire.
He does have... You do have a little bit of forces, didn't you say?
Yeah, I got 3 forces. I should have some fire in here.
Really? 3 forces? I have 3 forces. We're equal in forces.
Yeah.
Dang.
I don't think I can... I don't think I can create fire, however. I can influence fire. Influence heat. Control heat. Control fire. I don't think I can just make fire.
They're already in heat.
I mean, you can create, you can call lightning.
That's not going to make fire.
It's hot.
Also, there's no storm where I can't get the lightning from anywhere.
You would still basically make the lightning.
It specifically says she cannot create lightning from nothing at this level. You must spell with an existing storm or one you set in motion with control.
Okay, yeah, I'm reading it now. Yeah.
Okay.
Control light could actually cause fire.
Yeah, but I need like a fireball, not like, you know, like I use a magnifying glass to burn an ant. Like these are bigger than ants. We need a big magnifying glass.
He just wants to burn the heresy.
I mean, yeah, of course. I don't think I can do fire. That's disappointing. No. Can I make fire with matter? I don't think so.
No. That's energy.
Well, yeah, I'm just gonna try it again. I'm just gonna try to turn another one into copper. It's not gonna work this time, but I'm gonna try it again.
Give me the roll.
So it should be the same 9, yep. I think, right? Yeah.
This one, it does turn into copper.
Okay. You know what? I don't understand magic, but we're rolling with it. Just a mage who has no idea how the hell they're doing anything, but it's happening.
Cool.
Happens.
So now, despite these things being levitate, or well, these next two things that are levitated, they weren't close enough to do anything. I'm actually going to mark out one. The one that is no longer copper that is in this initiative order is not within range to do anything. So, Catalina, you're up next.
Oh. So we're trying to kill them, right? That's what we all decided?
I mean, I've already killed 2 of them.
Oh.
And they attacked my dog.
They didn't attack.
They attacked dog.
They we probably bumped into a mating thing.
Dog did not consent. See, your dog is running away. He's not consenting.
Well, I get that, but to them, they were, I think to them, they were just doing natural
moral
things.
Relativity. We're Cthulhu dogs. We are automatically
better. Does this thing look natural to you?
I don't travel much.
Look, the dead one over there was leaking supernal energy that was being absorbed by the kidney. If these are the same things, they're supernal, they're not natural.
Not natural. And thus need to die? I mean, a lot of the things we do isn't natural. I'm just saying.
Yeah, and we're going to die one day too. I mean, we're just helping them along.
Okay.
And they attacked us.
Yeah, this is self-defense. I mean...
Did they attack you, or were they just trying to make love to you?
That's it. Same thing in this context. Assault is assault.
I wasn't attacked.
Do I need to pull up Fatal and get the grappling rules out?